All I got is piss warm chango.
That's my brand. This is damn good. I'd say this is the best beer I've ever had. Actually.
You need anything over there?
I'm just glad to be alive right now. I was up a few towns away. You know Saragossa? I was visiting a bar there, not unlike this one. They serve beer, not quite as good as this, but close. And I saw something you wouldn't believe. I'm sitting there, see? Small table all by myself. Now this bar is full of real lowlives. I mean, not like this place here. No, I mean bad. Like they were up to no good, know what I'm saying? Anyway, I'm all by myself. I like it that way. Meanwhile, things are going on. Under the table kinds of things. Not too obvious, but not too secret either. So, I'm sitting there, and in walks the biggest Mexican I have ever seen. Big as shit. Just walks right in like he owns a place. Now, nobody knew quite what to make of him, or quite what to think. There he was, and in he walked. It was dark, too. I don't mean dark-skinned. Now, this was different. It was as if he was always walking in a shadow. I mean, every step he took towards the light, just when you thought his face was about to be revealed, it wasn't. It was as if the lights dimmed just for him.
Este huele a cagada.
So, this guy takes a seat at the bar, asks the bartender for a soda pop, sits back, says nothing.
You're a soda pop.
Now, I wasn't interested in his drink. No, I was more interested in what he was carrying when he walked in. Some sort of a suitcase, kind of heavy. And he sat that thing on a stool beside him as if it were his girl.
Well, one.
Then, all of a sudden, the bastard spoke. He started talking low and whispered with the bartender. And you know he was talking business, because whatever he said upset the bartender. Especially when he mentioned, he said something like, bitch, or Bucho. That's what it was. Bucho. Well, whatever he said, pissed off the bartender plenty. Oh, and some of those unsavory characters I was telling you about, not class acts like these boys here, but real scum, they got pissed too. Started pulling guns and knives and what have you, starting some shit. Now the stranger, he bolts out of the bar stool like you wouldn't believe. He grabs his case and he dives right in the middle of the room with it. Just dives right in. Now, I don't know what he does on that floor, but he's up in two shakes, his suitcase is wide open, and he's pulled God knows what out of it, but it's the biggest hand cannon I've ever fucking seen.
Stood there while this whole thing was going down, you didn't run for cover or join in?
I was frozen stiff. All I could do was watch this. Bing teared the place apart. I mean, it was amazing. Cutthroat scumbags were coming out of the woodwork and dying much deserved deaths. Now, don't get me wrong. This was no class act group of guys like you got in here. Not at all. These guys were world-class turds. And I'm sorry, but they got what they deserved. It was judgment night in that place. So he grabs one of these guys, the only guy that's still breathing. And he starts getting information out of him. And I just knew, by the whispering and all, that this guy was giving up all the goods, spilling his guts, confessing the world. He told that stranger everything.
everything?
Can I get a cleaner mug? This one's dirty.
Fuck you, man. It's the cleanest one I got.
So anyway, without warning, without any hint or preview, a stranger whips around and he sees me.
You saw his face?
His face? No. His eyes.
To you?
Not really, because he turned his attention back to the guy on the floor. The stranger shot him, walked over to the bartender, paid, and left.
So the bartender lived. The bartender never gets killed.
But as the stranger neared the door, no, man. The bartender got it worse than anybody.
Here. This one's on the house. If you can remember his face.
Thanks. But no thanks. I'm clearing out of here, boys. Because I think he's headed this way.
Well, thank you, boys. Y'all take care.